Hello learners, I am Vinita Garg, HOD Computer Science, and in this video lesson, we will talk about constructors and destructors. After going through this video lesson, you would be able to familiarize with constructor and its types, define constructor with default arguments, and the usage of destructor. We have already learned that initialization of variables is must before using them, because otherwise they may contain garbage value. Similarly, initialization of data members is also essential. But the problem with the class is that at the time of declaring a class, we cannot assign any initial value to its data members, as the class specification only provides a template and does not allocate any memory space to the data members. The necessary memory space is allocated to data members only when the object of the class is created. So, we cannot assign any value to the data members before the object of that class can be created. For that reason, there are special member functions which have been declared inside the class to give the initial values to the data members of the class. We can see in this example, if we assign the value 1 to roll number and 10 to marks, this will give an error because at present no memory space has been allocated to these data members. So, this is wrong and should be avoided. Constructor. A constructor is a special member function that initializes the objects of its class. Some of the features of constructor are: constructor has the same name as that of the class. It does not have any return type, not even void. It is called automatically when the object of the class is created. And it is called constructor because it constructs the values of data members of the class. So, let us declare a constructor. A constructor is declared and defined as follows. We take an example of a class student with private data members as roll number and marks. In the public section, we will define a constructor of this class. We can see here, the constructor has the same name as that of the class followed by parentheses. The body of the function contains the initialization statements of the members of the class, especially data members. You can see here, we have assigned the value 10 to roll number and marks, we have assigned the value 50.5. Now, at present, no value will be assigned to these data members. Now, in main, when we create the object of this class using the statement students2, at that time, memory will be allocated to the data members of the class, roll number and marks, and the constructor function will be invoked automatically and assigns value 10 to roll number and 50.5 to marks. It is very essential to note down that constructors should be declared in the public section of the class, and if they are declared in the private section, then object won't be able to access it or invoke it. Constructor invocation. A constructor can be called in two ways, implicitly or explicitly. Let us understand it with the help of an example. Now, we'll take the example of class student again with private data members as roll number and marks. And in the public section, we are declaring the constructor which has the name student again, which is the same name as that of the class. And in the body of the function, we are assigning some initial values to the data members. Now, in void main, when we give the statement student S1, so object S1 of class student will be created, and at that time only the constructor of the class will be called automatically. So, as we are not calling the constructor explicitly, this is the implicit call of constructor. Now, let us take another example. Again, we are defining a class student with private data members as roll number and marks, and in the public section, we are declaring a constructor student where we are initializing the data members roll number by 0 and marks by 0.0. Now, in the main, we give the statement student S1 equal to student followed by a set of parentheses. You can see here that in this example, the object S1 will be created and simultaneously the constructor function will be invoked. And here we are calling the constructor explicitly. That is why this type of call is called explicit call of constructor. Types of constructor. Usually there are three types of constructors: default constructor, parameterized constructor, and copy constructor. Default constructor is a constructor that accepts no parameters. Parameterized constructor accepts values of data members as parameters. And copy constructor again accepts parameters, but in the case of copy constructor, the parameter is a reference of an object of the same class. Let us understand them with the help of an example. So, default constructor, as we have learned, is the constructor that accepts no parameters. So, let us take an example of a class student again with private data members as roll number and marks. And in the public section, we are declaring a constructor which has the same name as that of the class, and we are assigning the initial value 0 to roll number and 0.0 to marks. So, in void main, this is what we have already done, is a default constructor only. Now, in main, the statement student S1 will create the object S1 and invoke the constructor student implicitly. So, you can see the moment the object S1 is created, the memory will be allocated to its data members, roll number and marks, and the constructor will be called and it will assign the initial values 0 to roll number and 0.0 to marks. In the second statement, we have given student S2 is equal to student followed by a set of parentheses. This is an explicit call of default constructor. In this statement also, an object S2 will be created, and the moment S2 is created, memory is allocated to its data members, roll number and marks. You can see in the memory diagram, and the default constructor will be invoked and assign the value 0 to roll number and 0.0 to marks. And very important to note that if no such constructor is defined, then the compiler supplies a default constructor, and in that case it is called nothing to do constructor. Now let us talk about parameterized constructor. Parameterized constructor takes parameters, and these parameters are the values of data members. So, let us understand it with the help of an example. So, we are taking the example of class student again. So, in class student, there are two data members, roll number and marks, which are private data members. Now, in the public section, we are declaring the constructor student, in which we are passing int roll comma float mark as parameters to supply values to roll number and marks of the class student. So, in the body of the parameterized constructor, we will write roll number equal to roll and marks equal to mark. That is, we are assigning the value roll to roll number and mark to marks. Now, in the main, the statement student S1 10,350. So, with this statement, then object S1 will be created, and these parameters will be passed to the parameterized constructor, and 10 will be assigned to the data member roll number and 350 will be assigned to the data member marks. So, you can see in the memory diagram of S1, memory is allocated to roll number and marks, and the values 10 and 350 will be stored in the data members roll number and marks respectively. This is the implicit call of parameterized constructor. And the second statement is student S2 is equal to student 20,400. So, this is the explicit call of parameterized constructor in which we are calling the parameterized constructor explicitly. So, the values 20 and 400, they will be passed to the parameterized constructor. Then object S2 is created and memory will be allocated to its data members roll number and marks, and then 20 will be assigned to the data member roll number and 400 is assigned to the data member marks. Copy constructor. A copy constructor again takes parameters, but the parameter here is a reference to an object of the same class. Let us understand it with the help of an example. So we are taking the example of class student again, which has two data members, roll number and marks, as private data members. And in the public section, we are first declaring the parameterized constructor student int roll comma float mark, and in the body roll number equal to roll and marks equal to mark. Now let us see the definition of copy constructor. Again, the name of the copy constructor is same as that of the class, that is student, and in the parameter we have student ampersand s, that is it is the reference of an object of the same class. Now in the body of the copy constructor, it is defined as roll number equal to s dot roll number and marks equal to s dot marks. So whatever is stored in the object s, that will be copied to the data members roll number and marks. Now let us go to main to see the execution. Now the first statement is student s1 10,350. So in this case, as the values of the data members are parameters, so parameterized constructor will be called. You can see the memory diagram. The memory space will be allocated to the data members of the object s1, and roll number will take the value 10 and marks will take the value 350. Now the next statement is student s2, and within braces we are writing s1. So in this case, the parameter is an object itself. So in this case, copy constructor will be invoked. And s1 and s, you can see in the copy constructor, they will share the same memory, and the data of s1 is used to initialize the data members of s2. So in roll number we will get as value 10 and marks will get the value 350. Now let us see the next statement, which is student s3 equal to s1. Now in this case also, copy constructor will be invoked, and s1 is passed as the values of s1 will be shared with s, and the data members of the object s3 will get values 10 and 350. So you can see the diagram again, memory diagram. Now let us see the next statement. We have declared an object s4 of class student, and then we are saying s4 equal to s2. So please note down carefully that in this case, copy constructor will not be invoked, and only the members of S2, they will be copied to S4. No copy constructor would be invoked at this time. So the process of initialization through a copy constructor is known as copy initialization. And one very important point that is to be noted is that the object should be passed by reference. If you do not pass the object by reference, then a copy constructor would be invoked again to make the copy of the object. And again, in the definition of the copy constructor, again we are asking it to make a copy. So copy constructor will be invoked again, and this process will become recursive, that is it will be called again and again, and ultimately you will run out of your memory and your system will hang. So please be careful that in the copy constructor, object is always passed by reference. Constructors with default arguments. Now we can also declare constructors with default arguments. Let us understand this concept with the help of an example. We are taking an example of a class student with data members as roll number and marks. In the public section, we are declaring a parameterized constructor, which is student, and then the parameters are int roll comma float mark, and this time we are assigning the value 100 to the parameter mark. The body will remain the same, roll number equal to roll and marks equal to mark. Now let us see in main. The first statement is student s1 10,350. So the object s1 will be created, and memory space will be allocated to its data members roll number and marks, and the value 10 will be assigned to the data member roll number and 350 to marks. Let us see the next statement, student s2 and within parenthesis 20. Please note down that we are passing only one single value. So in this case, the default arguments will work. So the value 20 will be passed to rule and mark will take the value 100. So the object S2 is created and roll number will be assigned the value 20 and marks will be assigned the value 100. This is how the default arguments work. Destructor. Destructor is again a special member function of a class which is used to destroy the objects that have been created by constructor. The destructor is a member function again whose name is same as that of the class and it is preceded by a tilde sign. So let us understand it with the help of an example. So we are taking the example of class student again with data members as roll number and marks. Now in the public section we are declaring a constructor student and we are assigning some default values 0 to roll number and 0.0 to marks. Let us now declare a destructor. We can see a tilde sign followed by the name of the class and this is followed by a set of parentheses. And in the body of the destructor we are simply displaying I am a destructor. So this is how you can define a destructor in a class. Again, destructor should be in the public section because they are also invoked by the object. Let us see some important features of destructor. Destructor is a member function with the same name as that of the class and is preceded by a tilde sign. You have already seen this. It never takes any argument nor does it return any value. It will be invoked by the compiler upon exit from the program or the function or the block in which it is defined to clean the storage. It is always a good practice to declare destructor in a program because it releases memory space for future use. It is always declared in public section. Please remember this. And there can be only one destructor in a class. We can have many constructors, but we can have only one destructor in a class. Now let us understand the working of constructor and destructor with the help of another example. Here I am taking the example of class student with only one data member as roll number. In the public section, we are declaring all type of constructors and destructor. So let us see the definitions. Student, which is a default constructor, it assigns value 0 to roll number and there is a cout statement default constructor called. Now student again, the second parameterized constructor which has roll as the parameter, it is assigning the value of roll to roll number and the cout statement is parameterized constructor called. The next statement is of the copy constructor which is student and within parenthesis student ampersand s. And here we are assigning the value s dot roll number to roll number. And the cout statement is copy constructor called. The last function is a destructor function. You can see it is preceded by a tilde sign and has the same name as that of the class. And in this we have one single statement cout destructor called. Now let us go to the main. In main, the first statement is student s1. As no parameters are being passed, so S1 will call the default constructor. So 0 will be assigned to roll number and the statement default constructor called will be displayed on the screen. As you can see in the output window, you can see the first statement default constructor called. Now the next statement is student S2 and within brackets 10. So in this case, as we are passing the value of data member as parameter, so parameterized constructor will be called and it will assign value 10 to roll number and it will display parameterized constructor called in the output window. You can see the second statement parameterized constructor called. Let us see the third statement in main student S3 and within parenthesis S2. So in this case as we are passing an object as a parameter, so copy constructor will be invoked and the roll number of S2 will be copied to roll number of S3. And the statement copy constructor called will be shown in the output window. Now the next statement is student S4 and within parenthesis S2. So in this case, as we are passing the data value as parameter, so parameterized constructor will be called and it will assign the value 2 to roll number and it will display the statement parameterized constructor called in the output window. Now the last statement is student S5 equal to S4. So in this case, again the copy constructor will be invoked and the data member of S4, value of the data member of S4 will be copied to S5 and the statement copy constructor called would be invoked. Now you can see the main is over and your program is also over. For all the constructors, whatever objects have been created, now the destructor will be called for each one of them one by one to destroy them and to free the memory space allocated by used by these objects. You can see in the output window, we have destructor call statement 5 times. This is for all the 5 objects which have been created in this program. So for every object that is created, the destructor is called to free up the memory space and destroy that object. So this is how constructors and destructors work. So in this session, you have learned constructor and its types and destructor. So I hope the concepts are clear and you will be able to understand how they really work. Thank you.